Alright guys, welcome back to State of Decay, right back with another episode, leaving right back where I left off, and I've decided that I'm gonna go clear out this infestation first, and then I'll deal with the survivors, because I realize that these guys are really close to this first potential house, and if I end up having to get into a bit of trouble, then I'm gonna have an issue with this infestation, and I don't want to go down with Marcus. I prefer to have two survivors to play with at one time, so I'm just gonna be. Oh wow, he just went to the floor. He tried to confuse me, seriously. So he's down. I'm gonna set these guys with my car. And then I'll head on down to this bathroom here, which is an issue because this bathroom is like really, 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 really. So let me just let them. I'm gonna draw them out. And I. Look at that. Look at them hop this fence. Come on. Come on, guys. You're taking too long. Oh, he flopped. He tried to swing and he flopped. Oh, my goodness. That's hilarious. So, there's other ways I could obviously deal with this, right? I mean, I could come in here. I could come here just whacking zombies. But the fact that these infestations are... I think the infestations have more zombies than actual hordes. So, me doing that... Me trying to go in there with, you know, like an axe or something and trying to whack these guys, you know, by myself, I think it's a very bad idea. So I think that, you know, another way I could do it, obviously, is by taking a Molotov or something and whacking those guys with a Molotov and setting an entire room on fire. But at the same time, I think that draws a lot of attention. So I might as well just use the car. Correct. I believe that is a smart way to... I mean... I feel like I'm overusing cars. You know, this is a zombie game, and you really shouldn't be using cars this much because they draw a lot of attention. Obviously, that's one of the downfalls of using cars in a zombie situation, because apparently zombies want to check out all the latest models. And I feel like... Okay, let me get out the car because that horde is right around the corner. I don't want to have them coming over here. And then Marcus is also really tired. If I go in there swinging, like you see me taking swings here, I mean, if I'm trying to whack zombies, I mean, look, oh crap, what the, that guy came, oh my goodness, that pipe wrench is a beast. Strike to the face, he went down. Okay, there are my screamers, there we go. That's the ones I'm waiting for. It's two of them, like bowling pins. Like bowling pins. So this infestation is gone. And if this infestation comes back, they're supposed to, I think they're doing a patch so that infestations don't show up as frequently, because that's, I don't think that was their originally planned idea for the game, was having infestations just pop up as frequently as they do. And I think that's a good idea, because it's actually really annoying how frequently they do pop up. So let me, well, this horde is right here. Let me get out the car again. I know there was a zombie over here, so let me... That was a hit. Oh, no. Wait, did he just flop in front of me? Oh, that's the one I killed earlier. Two strikes down to the ground. Apparently, this guy doesn't want to rush me. There we go. Strike to the head. Alright, so that horde is right there. As much as I want to run them over... Smart idea would be to not run them over, because I don't want to draw that much attention. And this actually, I think it shows you how many shots you have left in your suppressor before it breaks. So I think that six means I have six shots left, because apparently each weapon has 30 shots before it goes bad. So let me start walking this way. Let me walk across the street. I think that horde is going to turn around in a second. And there were two survivors, so if I managed to find both of them, and they did say they had kids, which I don't know which, I don't know if that was a lie or not, but if they do have kids, then I don't know how that impacts the game. I mean, did we take the kids with us, or was he, I'm pretty sure he was lying, I'm pretty sure. I also want to use a, you can shoot propane tanks and blow stuff up, I want to do that eventually. Alright, so let me head in here.
Anybody home?
I've been in this house before. I know that there's no one in here. So this house is clear. Which means I need to head to the next house. Oh, they want me to check all the rooms first. Wow, they're leaving doors open. Someone is getting attacked. Or that whore is just being really loud. Okay.
Time to move on.
Okay, next house. Which is right behind me. Cool. So let me hop over this fence. Or check the garage. Oh, nice. They're in here. They gotta be. No, this wasn't...
Consider this one searched.
Well, this wasn't locked last time I was here, so... That's weird. And one more house to check. They gotta be in here, right? And now, out of all the houses in this town, why would they assume they're only in these three areas? It's kind of weird, right?
Anybody home? Hey, come here.
So, one room. Gotta be upstairs. There's a zombie outside. I want to be careful. Let's check this out first. I've actually never been in this house. This is weird. I mean, there's all these houses close to our base, and I've never checked them out. So we got two flares here. Let's just grab those. I guess those could replace the... Whatchamacallit? The fireworks? In a sense. But the fireworks have a noise effect to it, rather than the flares having just a light effect. There's a... Oh, nice. Let's take the construction materials.
I'm loaded up. See you back at base.
Grab some more flares. And they should be in this room.
What you want?
Why don't you come with me? We've got room.
Really? My God, thank you. I thought for sure we were gonna die out here.
Alright, cool. So I have two survivors. This is interesting because now I have... Well, okay, so they did lie about having kids. There's no kids here. So let's head downstairs and... I'll try to get these guys back to the main house as fast as possible. So I need to go out the front door, which should take us straight. And that was a wow. Why did I do that? We need to go out the. I don't even know which door is the front or not. But let me check this. And they won't mind because this ain't their house. Energy drink, I'll take it. Hopefully there's something in here for me to grab. Okay, so I can take the frying pan. Oh, that's interesting. Does Marcus have a bigger bag than... Cause I think the limit for Maya was 20 pounds or something like that. I don't know. Let's see. Can... of food. Let me see how much food do we have. We have 6 rations or 6 something. I don't know. I'll just come back and get this myself because, like I said in the last episode, sending people to pick up food is honestly, I mean, sometimes it works and sometimes these people are just retarded. So let's keep on climbing fences and all that good stuff. And heading back home. I think we should. Let me not use the car. Well, you know what? Marcus is tired, so I think this is probably a good time to use the car. And this is the damaged car anyway, so let me just take this back to the house. And that's actually pretty interesting. Like, with the other survivors, the other neighbors, there was a...
What did those soldiers want anyway?
That beats the hell out of me. They just showed up, dragged us out onto the street, and sent in those guys in hazmat suits. Started taking a bunch of samples, talking about infection vectors and a bunch of shit I didn't understand. I think that woman was in charge, Captain Montresor or something. Not like she even looked at us.
How's it going?
I'm almost there.
That's it, right up there. Make yourselves at home.
You don't know what this means to us.
Okay, I keep being interrupted, but with the other survivors that we found, the other neighbors, there was a trust system implied, and you know, you have to build up trust, I guess, and they would come on in, girl. You go be in the kitchen. No, I'm just playing. That's rude. Let me not say that, but all right, so we dealt with an infestation. How is my morale still going down? I just dealt with one. Well, so let me drop this stuff off.
There you go. Don't say I never gave you nothing.
What you got?
Oh, you know, stuff.
All right, so can I switch these guys? I can switch to new people. Yes, so what is... Oh, she's an alcoholic. Okay, so... I don't know. She's apparently really good. She's got 4-star beer pong, so I guess that's cool. And this guy, whose name is Brady Scott, no gun, played golf. He's got 2-star cardio. So, I mean, eventually, you know, I'm going to switch to him eventually, but... I mean, we're doing a pretty good job here. We do have one more infestation out to this area over here, which I will happily deal with by myself let me switch off to Maya because Marcus is pretty tired. And I think that I should start working on some more suppressors or... Actually, how much materials do I have? Because I kind of want to go build another house. Or move to another... location, and this machete is broken, or it's almost broken, so we have 100 rounds. Wow, I get that ammo cache was a beast ammo cache. Look at all this stuff. I mean, we almost have 100 rounds for all these weapons, for all these ammos. We have 4 grenade launcher ammos, which I don't even why would I ever use a grenade launcher? That would make so much noise, it's not even funny. So a wrench, a rusty machete, a pipe threader. I really want another tomahawk. That would be pretty cool. I need another tomahawk, so wonder how that would turn out.
Hey, you feeling patriotic? We could use your eyes to help us clear out some Zeds.
So the army wants my help. That sounds pretty fun. I don't want to help the army like at all, but I mean the fact that I get to see some artillery, I think that this sounds like a setup. I don't know if I trust these army guys, but this sounds like a setup. And I'm still sitting here. I don't know which weapon I want. It should be good to go. Is that a whore to our back? I mean, you guys hear that too, right? Probably not. It's probably like, what, 1 or 2 zombies? Oh, I see one. Barely. Alright, so let me... Maya's suppressor, I think, is gone. So let me grab the other suppressor that I made. I'm spending too much time in here. Hold on. I'll get out of here eventually. Okay. Homemade suppressor. I'll go ahead and detach that. Yep, and it tells you I have 30 shots. That's cool. So I didn't notice that earlier. Let me reload my gun. I wonder if I can find a scope for this gun specifically. But I haven't seen anything yet, so let me just head out of here. And I'm going down to the bathroom area, or the public restroom, so that shouldn't be too much of an issue. Let's work on Maya's cardio. There we go. Nice. Oh, crap. Wow. Seriously? Oh, wow. Seriously? Okay, there we go. Now he's down. That was kind of BS. I don't know what that was about. So now we have to head down here and deal with spotting
our
the
spotted a new group of survivors. Should be on your map.
More survivors. I think I left construction materials in here. Or I don't know what this is. Okay, let me bust this down. This is just like that first shed that we found. There should be some Molotovs in this barrel. Or a gallon of gasoline. Which shouldn't be next to each other. Hopefully they're not both in here. Nothing found. Wow.
Was that free here?
Alright, so there's a rusty kukri, which I think, forgot who uses these, crap, I can't remember, so, let me keep on searching, hopefully I can find some more stuff in here. There's a flat screen that I want to take with me. Oh, wow, another machete. Nope, I'm taking this one with me. I didn't mean to press that. Let's load the rucksack.
I'm bringing this stuff home. We'll see you soon.
And I got some more stuff with me. I got a lot of melee weapons out of this. Or I got a lot of melee weapons with Meyer right now. Wow. A hockey stick. Oh my, wow. That's, I'm gonna take that with me. And then I'll radio home for someone to come get this. So let me use 10 influence.
I found some supplies. Send runners for pickup.
They'll be on their way soon.
And hopefully they don't send the new guys, because I don't know how well they're going to hold up. I don't want to build an outpost here. I think that that's a little too close to home. I need to focus on getting this other house dealt with, so let me head back up the road, which should be to my, yep, okay, so I'm gonna go this way. I'm gonna take that tricycle with me. Oh, this is not good. Oh, no, I'm tired. But I can outrun a zombie by not sprinting. Okay, I can outrun a zombie by not sprinting. Wow, didn't know I could do that. Pretty sure I can't do that with all the zombies, but with this one, apparently I can't. Let me turn, okay, I'm running into stuff, let me turn around. Oh no, wait, who did they send? Who is that? Oh, they sent Ed? Oh, Ed's back on the move. Ed's going down. He's running through houses, man. What are you doing?
I could use some food.
Oh, this is not good. Okay, so I need to... I didn't know Ed was just gonna... Oh my... Okay, let me get back. Can I get back to the car to save Ed? I'm not gonna make this. I'm not gonna make it through this. Okay. Let me slow down. I should've dropped some of that gear. I should've waited to... Oh, okay, I got this car here, though. I'm gonna try to cover him the best I can, even though this is probably gonna make it even worse, but I need to make sure that I keep as many survivors as possible. I didn't even see if I could switch to Ed. And this car is so badly damaged. This is why I just left this at the road, because it's...
You wanna see just about the coolest way to kill Zeds ever?
I'll be there in a second. But I gotta help Ed out. Make sure that he doesn't die. He keeps hopping the same fence over and over again.
We're here.
Give me a few more minutes. There's a zombie coming right for him. There's nothing to search. I hate when you tell them to pick something up and they search it like I haven't searched it already. Like, if it told me that it's been searched, I mean, they're just spending extra minutes in there that they don't have to spend. Alright, so let me go check on Ed, because I want to make sure that he gets back okay. And he's over. I checked this already.
In the meantime, alright, be ready in a minute.
And when this happens, zombies will rush. This happens every time. I shouldn't have done this. Alright, so let me... Also, surprisingly, there are no... Oh, there's... Oh, see, there we go. There's two zombies coming from the backyard. I just intercept these guys before they get to the door. Oh, I left the door open. Oh, I'm sorry. Almost got Ed killed. Okay, Ed needs to hurry up. Because there's about five zombies coming this way.
Let's move.
Come on. Get in the car, Ed. Nice. So we have two sets of construction materials now. Another stealth attack. Oh, wow. That didn't work. Okay, so that's done. Where's the military?
Okay, I'm here. What now?
Find yourself a good spot to get a bird's eye view.
Okay, so I'm going back up to... She probably can't take much more climbing. Which I don't have. I keep forgetting I grab these food stockpiles and I don't take what's in them when I get back to the house. So I keep grabbing like ammo and stuff and weapons, and I keep forgetting to grab food, which is very important because all I have is... What, two Molotovs? I think I have, like, another firecracker. No, I don't have any firecrackers. I use all those. Yeah, so this is actually working out pretty well. Okay, so let's survey.
Okay. Now we're looking for high concentrations of brain-eating assholes. Let us know what you find.
I got nothing left. Spotted a weird one. That's not a normal zombie.
A SWAT zombie? What's us? Oh, I need to see that. That looks.
Tell Eric he owes us.
What is a SWAT zombie?
Spotted a weird one.
It's another group.
In position.
Find yourself a good spot to get a bird's eye view. And we're done here. Enjoy your new smoking crater. Target confirmed. Duck and cover, folks. If anything survived that, you got bigger problems.
So there's more stuff? I don't see anything else. Survey. Unless it's below me. So I think, am I done here? I guess I'm done here. Okay, so that's all finished. I think we're good here, and I think I can go ahead, and it's telling me that I need to establish more outposts. So I think that what I'm going to do now is head over to the Kirkman residence, and I'm going to go establish a house there really fast. Wait, who's out? Ally in trouble. What is going on? Who is outside? I mean, I shouldn't be the only person searching for stuff, but I mean, still, like, this doesn't really make any sense. And I want to see what a SWAT zombie looks like, but then again, I don't want to see what it looks like because I kind of don't like zombies with special names. And I should have brought a car. And she's tired. She's exhausted. She's been out too long, even though she really hasn't been out that long, which is kind of weird. But there should be a car in here. Because I
you're going to burn yourself out if you don't come home and rest a little.
I leave cars where they are sometimes because I realize it is better to have cars just sitting at their homes rather than driving and taking every car that's out there. So I need to, what's the best way to do this? They're kind of near their Wilkerson's, so I'll just take this, this car sucks at turning. Ooh, that was a nice drift, but dirt road should be up. Seriously, there's one infestation, right? And I've done a pretty good job clearing these things out, but for some reason they keep telling me, oh, there's too many infestations, you're losing morale. Let me just tire these hordes up here, man. This is like doing too much. Kill the horde, good to go. Let me run over this straggler up here. Why is this guy? He brought out lawn chairs.
All right, you're safe. Let's go. Let's go.
Who is this? Oh, it's Jacob. What is he doing out here? I mean, I kind of don't have a choice but to save him because if I leave him out here, then he's pretty much toast. I mean, this horde just respawn. I was wondering why he was stuck on my hood for so long. This is gonna, alright, so let me drive back up here. I'm just gonna drive past this horde. I really don't care at this point. Wait, what? What is this objective? What is that? Belongings, Virginia Dahlgreen? I'm confused. What am I supposed to do? I have no idea what that means. I really don't, and I'm really confused. So we're just gonna run all the way back. Let's go, Jacob. Let's not make this too easy. Let the horde have fun with that car there. Wow, she just ran right past us. I guess that car was making a lot of noise. I mean, look at all the cars we have here. I mean, we have the blue sedan. We have two trucks. We have the muscle car. We have that exotic car. And then we have a police car. I mean, this is a pretty...
You got it from here?
Okay, so I totally wasn't able to do what I wanted to do in this episode, which was build the house, which was really annoying. I thought I would be able to at least get that done towards the end, but I guess not. And if anybody else goes adventuring out, you guys are by yourselves, because I don't feel like dealing with this. and Karen Tolbert is hurt. I don't know how, because she was fine earlier. Maybe if she wasn't drinking so much, she wouldn't be so tired. But oh, I can switch to Sam too. Oh, I didn't know. See, I'm sitting here and I'm thinking I can't switch these people, and I can. And I can switch to Ed. So I wonder how that just happened. That's weird. And you know what? Alan, he's kind of being a dick right now. But I'll deal with him in the next episode. I want to thank you guys for watching this one. And if you enjoyed the episodes, as always, leave a like or a comment letting me know how much you guys enjoyed the episodes. And I will see you later. I'm out of here. Bye.